Right.
We've got some big smiles from away back there. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Just get one out of the way first of all. Your friend and former colleague Gary Monk back in football, have you spoken to him?
Well, I just wish him the best of luck. I think in the end of the day, he's in charge of a very big club now, and I just wish that he will do well. But in the end, we're very focused here on for anything that happened. We're very focused on taking our club forward, and our focus is on that.
Speaking of which, I haven't spoken to you since Josh came here on trial. I'm guessing you may have seen some footage from Monday and had reports. How did he get on?
It's good. He's been having a few trainings with us. The club thought they could be good to have a look at him. So just ask the club enough time so we can have a proper assessment. And if we ask him to play on Monday to have a better assessment and give him the right opportunity. He needs to obviously get fitter with more trainings that he is doing. And in the end of the week, or in the end of the next week, I will give the club my opinion, and obviously they can take a decision.
Obviously, it's early days. You haven't signed him or made that decision yet. But what, in terms of the type of player he is, what does he bring that's different in the field you have?
For what I've seen until now, is a player that if it's comfortable on the ball, and is a player who links up well from the back to the front. It's a feels more comfortable on a midfield role, and probably is a player that needs to be playing with someone else in the middle. Yeah.
Wanted to ask you about Jude Bellingham. What a couple of weeks he's had, obviously, with his goal against Stoke, and then a fantastic week with England.
Yes, and I think especially for England, because I can imagine for a young player like him, representing your country and captaining it and achieving success is to be massive. And the fact that he came in and helped the team the way he did on the last game against Stoke, because an important player of the team got injured and he was the option picked to replace him and had an impact in the game. I can imagine there's been a very intense 2 weeks for him. But I would like everyone to remember that it's our duty to protect him as well, and to understand that he's a little bit on a cloud and we are all a little bit, but I need to make sure that he can contribute and he can work. And I saw him this morning. He managed to train with us for 30 minutes, because obviously he's been playing three games for England plus our game with Stoke. Everyone can see that's a lot of games in less than 2 weeks. So we had to tailor a little bit down the training today. So we're all very happy. It's not only me, his teammates, we're all very happy. At the same time, we have a squad, and we're all together in that, and everyone is very happy for him, but we're strong together as a team, and we have a lot of other good players as well.
And lastly for me, Charlton obviously started the season very well. What are their main threats?
Charlton, you mean?
Yeah. So,
well, it's a very strong team when they play forward. They have a lot of mobility up front, a lot of confidence, a very good link between the midfield and the strikers. The fullbacks get in attack very well and attack well on the box. I would consider them a strong team when it comes to attack. And they have scored a lot of goals, especially at home, and they will feel very confident. So, despite that, I do trust in our team as well. We have our strengths, and we're having a good progression forwards, and we had a very good start in the league till the first international break. It's only 4 points difference between us and Charlton, and we have a lot of confidence for Saturday. Yeah.
Thanks, Pep. Good luck.
Thank you very much.